Next, we will explain about our second question in the practical part of the CCIE 350401 ENCOR written exam. Now, let's talk about an experiment on VRRP. So the question is actually very simple, students, so it doesn't have many command lines. So let's look at the requirements. The first question states we need to configure on switch 1 and switch 2. We are going to use such a VRRP, so the required group number is 200. The required group number is 200, and the virtual IP address I told you is 192.168.1200. Look at the address of VLAN 100 on switch 1. It is 1.1.2 switch 2's SVI VLAN. 100 interface address is 1.3, so our virtual IP address is 1.200. You don't need to worry too much about being on the same network segment. Then the second question said, we require the configuration on the switch, need to adjust its priority to 200. By default, the VRRP priority is always 100, so that's what it means. We request switch 1 to become the master device of our VRRP. Switch 2 becomes the backup device for our VRRP. Then it is said that switch 1 and switch 2 must exchange VRRP hello packets every 20 seconds. We need to adjust the announcement time to 20 seconds. Actually, the three requirements are not difficult. Let's do it step by step. So log into the environment, switch 1, switch 2. We will conduct testing on PC1 later. Looking at our VLAN's SVI like this. Check if our virtual IP address can be accessed. Is it accessible? Let's start by looking at switch 1. So we need on one of its SVI interfaces. We use the command show IP interface brief. We go into its interface. VLAN 100 interface. Run VRRP group number is 200 VRRP 200. So the virtual IP address is 192.168.1200. Done. Then ask us for the configuration of switch 1. The priority is 200, then VRRP 200. Priority 200. The default is 100, right? Then our VRRP is default to be active. We don't need to hit such a preempt. No need to open the echo station. It is enabled by default. Deal with it. The same goes for switch 2 here. We go inside the same interface. VLAN 100 VRRP group number 200. Virtual IP address 192.168.1200. Similarly, we don't need to change the priority on our end. Just 100 by default is fine. In this case, certainly, our switch 1 will become our master. Regarding switch 2, definitely a backup after doing this well. We connect the two switches. Adjust the VRRP timer a bit. VRRP 200, our timer's advertised. Adjust the timing of our announcement. Set to announce every 20 seconds, that's good. Students back here, VRRP 200 timers. In fact, we only need to adjust our master device such an advertised time. Our backup device will automatically learn, in theory. Actually, switch 2 doesn't need adjustment. However, for safety reasons, let's make some adjustments as well. VRRP 200 timers advertise every 20 seconds. Let's notify our team once. Notify once about our VRRP hello. So once it's done, after doing this thing well, let's go show VRRP brief. If we want to be able to see, we switch 1 should be our master device, switch 2 should be the backup device. We see that the switches show VRRP. Switch 1 is the master, switch 2 is the backup. That's no problem because we just configured this switch. Hello package notification time. Switch 2 has exceeded 3 seconds. By default, it sends a hello packet every second. After 3 seconds, no time after 3 seconds. Switch 2 exceeded the time limit. Did not receive the hello packet from the other party. They think our master device has crashed. So, switch 2 has become the new master. Let's extend the duration of this hello. So they waited until after the exchange later. The switch only knows it is the master device. Well, there was a slight issue with what I just said. So in the end, we will be able to see during the show. On our switch 1 side, it is the master. On the side of switch 2, it is set as backup. Show VRRP is backup. So the task is completed. The interval for announcements is every 20 seconds. After completing this question, we can now save the configuration. Save configuration. Of course, then you can detect, let's check if our configuration is correct. We have this terminal equipment. Go ping its virtual address. Ping 192.168.1.200. See if it can be pinged through. If you can ping successfully, we don't have any major issues. Then save the configuration. We can move on to the next question now. So if you still want to understand regarding our new information about CCIE certification, welcome to contact our Wolf Lab. Then let's move on to the next question. Goodbye. Goodbye.